Aces of the Class of 2016, use SourceTree. If I could offer you only one tip for the future, SourceTree would be it. The long-term benefits of version control have been proved by many devs, whereas the rest of my advice has no basis more reliable than my own coding experience. I will dispense this advice now. Roll intro. Hello Ace, this is RetroTK2 and welcome to this version control tutorial. Today we're installing SourceTree. I'll be discussing what version control is in the next video Ace, but we'll need this first. So let's get started. Fire up Chrome, type SourceTree into Google and it should be the first link. Click the download SourceTree free button and wait for it to download. When it's done, click the installer and when the dialog pops up, click next. Select the location for the install, click Next, and then click Install. When it's done installing, make sure the checkbox beside Launch SourceTree is checked and click Finish. When the dialog pops up, check the box beside I agree to the license agreement and click Continue. Click the Use Existing Account button. You'll need to create an account if you don't already have one, Ace. This account is a requirement to use SourceTree, Ace. It used to be that you could use SourceTree without it for 30 days, and after that it would ask you to sign it. This is similar to Visual Studio's 30-day message, but according to their website, this is no longer required and is for the best, Ace. Once logged in, click Continue and you'll be asked to connect with a remote repository. We'll cover this a little later, Ace. For now, click Skip Setup. SourceTree should open successfully. Feel free to pin SourceTree to your taskbar, Ace. A simple tutorial, but good to get it out of the way. And that's it. Rate, comment and subscribe, Ace. Tell me what you thought of the Sunscreen Parody. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com if you use version control with Unity. Thank you for watching this, and I'll see you in the next video.